So we didn't come all this way to find a campground. And after many hours on the highway, I was ready to diverge off the main road and into any side trail that looked promising. As it turned out, this one didn't show any initial promise, but I ventured in regardless. It wasn't showing up on my guide GPS, so either it was an old, defunct, overgrown trail, or something newly carved out of the brush. Seeing as there's a nicely stacked pile of firewood here, likely someone clearing some blowdown, I was beginning to think this may be possibly a trail to a hunting camp. As the trail was starting to get a little technical, I decided to utilize my custom-made utility arm for a third-person perspective. So when it comes to a camera boom shot, there are a couple of golden rules. One, don't display the boom prominently in the frame. And two, don't use the boom where it could possibly be ripped off your truck. With that taken care of, it was farther down the trail. Another small clearing, but overall, things were getting a little tighter and overgrown, most likely an ATV trail. With common sense getting the better of me, I decided it'd probably be best if I reeled in my curiosity and backed on out of here. After all, I am solo on this trip. If something were to go wrong down here, it wouldn't be easy to get help, so I decided to stop venturing off and look for something a little more accessible on the main road. That is until, of course, the very next side trail I come across. taking a look at the GPS satellite image. Zooming out, it looked like a nice lake just over my right, so it's a balance of risk versus reward, I guess. This was looking promising, however, access to the water was by foot only. No bueno. So back out and up the road we go. Besides forestry, there are many active mining claims in the area as well. Off in a distance, you can see the topography changing with some hills and ridge lines. Lots more side trails and lakes, but the main logging road goes on, and the day was still early, so we kept on going, getting closer and closer to the hills. Another beautiful lake on our right. And look at that, a pull-through trailer site, if you can believe that. The road was starting to get narrower and rougher the further we went in, so I decided to pull off at this fork and air down my tires a bit. It wasn't too much farther from here, we cross over one of the main rivers again, and then over my shoulder I saw it, the perfect spot for a stay. will do nicely. Time to set up. Jackson immediately took to the water to soak his old chalky bones as soon as he got out of the truck. He loves water soaks. I'm sure he'll also be ready for a nap after that long haul. At one end of the river, the sound of a babbling brook, and farther downstream, the whitewater sounds of the rushing water. Yep, just as I suspected. Out like a light. About this time of day, my viewers are probably expecting what I think they're expecting, and they'd be right. But you're probably also wondering, well, doesn't he drink more than one beer at a time? The obvious answer is yes. Yes, he does. However, I wouldn't want to subject my audience to watching me drink Pabst Blue Ribbon the entire episode, from cans. With the suds flowing, it was time to make some dinner. Thank you. Barbecue boneless, skinless chicken thighs, a broccoli summer salad, and a pint of beer. Delicious. And a little barbecue chicken for the red dog, of course. No matter where I am, wherever I eat, I always feel like I'm being watched. And I am. In reference to a Kevin Costner movie, if he comes around again tomorrow, I shall give him a name. Just another marvelous, perfect day drawing to a close. It doesn't get any better than this. A small fire before bed to wrap it all up, and then falling asleep to the sound of the river. We woke in the morning to yet another beautiful day. A nice hot cup of coffee to start things off right. Hello, glorious sunshine. Good morning, Two Socks. the street from me, there's a small bakery who make these bagels in a wood-fired oven. So delicious. With Jackson fed, he was all ready for his customary mid-morning nap. Meanwhile, I had some chores to take care of. One of the first and best accessories I bought for the Bronco was this tailgate table. It gets used constantly, so handy. With the sun moving overhead by midday, I improvised a shade for my dog using a tripod so he wouldn't have to move, and went about making lunch. Thank you. And again, all too quickly, the day has already drawn to a close. I'm sure going to miss this, spending time out here with my dog. And again, yet another beautiful morning. All packed up, coffee in hand, and ready for the road. Back up again and heading south down the 400. Seeing as I still had some vacation time left, I decided to break up the drive home with one more overnight stay, this time at beautiful Grundy Lake Provincial Park, not far from our first day layover. Positioned on the boundary of northern and southern Ontario, the woodlands here combine a real mix of forest species. With countless inland lakes and hiking trails, it's just a beautiful example of what Ontario Parks has to offer. And lucky us, we practically have the whole place to ourselves. Yet again, another day of perfect weather. Not even a couple of lazy late summer bees with a neighbor's generator can ruin this breakfast. However, unimaginable traffic might potentially derail my happy mood. It seems there's been an accident up ahead past Porta Barrel, and the highway is closed in both directions. Traffic was at a complete standstill for over an hour before they eventually cleared the scene and opened up the highway. You can see by the northbound traffic just how busy it can get up here, especially on long weekends. After clearing that mess, we come into the Barrie, Ontario traffic. I decided to take the most direct route home, so that entailed freeway driving straight into the GTA and eventually onto the 401. Traffic was heavy, as expected, but for the most part, we kept rolling right along and into the sunset.